Hello everyone, I am Dr. Siraj Ul Haq Faizi. I welcome you in my YouTube channel. Today in this video, I am going to talk about method of determining reaction mechanisms. So let us start learning of methods of determining reactions mechanism. So what is a mechanism of a reaction? This is a burning question in our mind. So friends, what is a mechanism of a reaction? So step by step descriptions of the reactions, informations about positions and shifting the moment and moment. So detailed reaction mechanism cannot be elucidated. My friend, the only proposed mechanism that is put forward. So energetically reasonable, account for the experimental observations in agreement with what is known about the analogous reactions. So method adopted for determining the mechanism of reaction. First, isotope labeling techniques. Second, stereochemical evidence. Third, crossover experiments. Then identifications of products. And then identifications of reaction intermediate. So let us start with isotope peak labeling technique. In this method, a single atom of any chemical compound is replaced by its isotopes. Tritium, deuterium, carbon-13, carbon-14, nitrogen-15 and oxygen-18 are the most common isotopes which are frequently used. So you can see in this reaction isotope labeling technique for ester hydrolysis. Ethyl acetate, it gives acetic acid and ethanol. So ethyl acetate, aryl oxygen or alkyl oxygen. Acetic acid and ethanol or acetic acid and ethanol. So you can see the where is the 18th carbon oxygen because we have labeled 18. Now friends, stereochemical evidence. Stereochemistry of the reactant and the product. Optically active substrates, optically inactive product, racemic mixture, SN1 mechanism. Optically active substrate, optically inactive product, and inverted configuration, Walden inversion, SN2 mechanisms. SN1 reactions, you know, you can see the slow RDAs, predetermining step and then fast, two step and single step reactions mechanism. So reaction occurs in two step but predetermining step in first step, so SN1. Hydrolysis of ethyl bromide, you can see the formation of transition state. This is example of SN2. Now friend, crossover experiments. To study the mechanism of molecular rearrangement reaction, intramolecular rearrangement or intermolecular rearrangement. Two non-identical reactants differ by one characteristic groups. So you can see the Frye's rearrangement, intermolecular and intramolecular mechanisms. So identification of the reaction intermediate. Reaction intermediates are an important class of chemical species which are quite helpful in understanding the mechanism of chemical reaction, isolation, detections and trapping. So what is the meaning of isolation? These species by nature are unstable under normal reaction condition, but they can be isolated under favorable conditions either in pure state or in their form of solution. The Hofmann rearrangement, MI2MA, formation of isocyanate intermediates, isolation of isocyanate intermediate. So Hofmann bromide reactions, you can see the formation of amine, formation of substituted amide, and this is the rearrangements, isocyanate, and then after decarboxylation you will get the amine. Diaphragm detections, stable intermediates, long lifetime, high concentration, detections by spectroscopic method. Fun fact, George Ola of California University got the Nobel Prize in 1994 for his work on cations. He was able to prepare a number of stable long life carbocations and recorded their carbon-13 NMR spectra. So trapping, intermediates that are not capable of being isolated as they are not quite stable or quite low in concentration are characterized by trapping them with a suitable reagent. And these reagents form product with the intermediate which are particularly characteristic of the species. So base promoted solubilities of chloroform when carried out in the presence of cyclohexene, the dichlorocarbene is trapped and adduct a cyclopropane derivative is obtained. So identification of products. Basic framework, reactants, intermediate products. Elucidation of the reaction mechanism, identifying intermediates, very short lifetime, low concentration, UV, IR, ESR, proton NMR, carbon-13 NMR, NMR suspectors. Technique you use for the identification. The reaction of orthochlorotoluene with a strong base not only gave the expected metacresol but also the unexpected orthocresol. The formation of both the product can only be explained by the formation of benzyne intermediate. So these are the reference, Advanced Organic Chemistry by Jagdamba Singh and Conceptual Organic Chemistry by Arun Seth. So my friends, I hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel and thanks for watching.